Hello, and welcome to the Office 365 New Features presentation for October 2013. As this is the first in our series of monthly new feature presentations, I've included just a few of the September new features as well. Moving forward, these monthly sessions will pertain only to the newest features made available the previous month. My name is John Horner, and I work as a partner solution consultant within the Global Partner Services Division of Microsoft. I will be facilitating this presentation today and want to personally thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to sit down and take a look at what's new in Office 365. So let's get started. As you are probably already aware, Office 365 is a continuously improving service focused on providing customers with new features that delight users and improve the productivity experience. Building a trusted service with high resiliency, hardened against attacks, broader certifications and compliance breadth, and responding to customer feedback. All of this provided with insights to help manage change to the service through customer communications and insight into upcoming changes. Before we take a look at new upcoming features, let's take a moment to walk through the process and types of changes in more detail. Office 365 has already been operating with many of these principles since launched nearly 2 years ago. Since we released Office 365 in 2011, we have followed our principle of continuous innovation to deliver features. Here is a small subset of features that have been shipped on monthly and quarterly basis to bring you great functionality like Exchange Hybrid Configuration, 64-bit DirSync Tool, and Link Mobile Clients, to name just a few. We continued on this trend in 2012 to expand our capacity and availability into Office 365 for government with the Government Cloud. We heard customer feedback to add DirSync for multi-forest Active Directory support, PDF support for SharePoint Online, and continued to invest in the cross-platform experience. With the release of the new Office in February 2013, we look forward to bringing innovation to our customers continuously. With improvements like Office Mobile for iPhone and Android, OWA for iPhone and iPad, and the Message Center, to name just a few. Office 365 provides insight to manage change and avoid surprises. Through the Office 365 Message Center, administrators can stay up to date by accessing critical information on such things as the end of support for Windows XP or Internet Explorer 8, for instance, or learn more about Office 365's client system requirements, as well as check out the latest What's New information. By signing up for compliance notifications in the Office 365 Settings tab, administrators can receive direct email notifications of maintenance tasks that may need addressing. Use the new Get Started with Office 365 landing page for one-stop access to great information and assistance for all users, Office 2013 Pro Plus client download for PC and Mac, and for assistance setting up your mobile devices. All of this includes online training videos containing great tips on working with Office 365. And don't forget to check out the Office 365 technology blog for the latest information pertaining to Office 365. Running a service brings Microsoft closer to the customer and enables us to collect more timely and relevant feedback to improve the service. As mentioned earlier, Office 365 has evolved its development process to a more agile approach to deliver monthly and quarterly service updates. And these improvements are also critical to being able to incorporate customer feedback more quickly than in the traditional package software model. Through many direct customer engagements, Microsoft is able to collect anecdotal feedback and product requests. Account teams and solution specialists document customers' desired capabilities. Customer executive briefings and large industry events are also great places where we connect directly with passionate users. A feature example that was often cited through these channels was the native PDF support in SharePoint. This update was shipped about 8 months after the service first launched and added PDF file extension recognition and in-browser viewing with the Adobe Reader plugin. First introduced during the Office 2010 public preview, the Send a Smile program has given users a quick in-product way to share their thoughts and a screenshot directly with Office Engineering. With the new Office Send a Smile is integrated into the final product. An example where customer feedback led to a direct UI change is the new sharing tab in Backstage, which used to have Save and Send in 2010. An important part of any service is the customer support. As customers experience issues or look for how to accomplish particular tasks, if those aren't easy for customers to solve on their own, they pick up the phone and call Microsoft. One example of how customer feedback led to direct UI change is the password policy change. When Office 365 shipped, in order to change the default password change policy, such as how many days before users were prompted to change their password, PowerShell commands were required. While not an issue for our large IT customers, this was not intuitive for many of our smaller mid-sized customers and partners using the service. Support helped engineering prioritize a feature to let admins modify the policy directly in the Office 365 administrative dashboard. So let's take a look at the Office 365 service updates for October 2013. We split them into three categories: Office Anywhere, Social, and Manage. Let's start with Office Anywhere updates. Office Anywhere updates for September and October 2013 include Power BI preview for Office 365, folder permissions in Outlook web app, calendar delegation in Outlook web app, shared with me, SharePoint online platform improvements, and Power Map preview refresh improvements for Excel. The rollout of the Microsoft Power BI preview for Office 365 began in August of 2013. But just what is Power BI? Power BI for Office 365 is a self-service business intelligence, or BI, solution delivered through Excel and Office 365. It can provide information workers with data analysis and visualization capabilities to deeper identify business insights either on-premises or within a trusted cloud environment. With Power BI for Office 365, customers can connect to data in the cloud or extend their existing on-premises data sources and systems to quickly build and deploy self-service BI solutions hosted in Microsoft's Enterprise Cloud. With Outlook web app, you can quickly and easily give a delegate permissions to view and modify the messages in your inbox or any other folder. The delegate can view your email on a tablet or smartphone by opening up Outlook web app with a compatible mobile browser or with an app such as OWA for iPhone or OWA for iPad. While a delegate can view your mail folder using Outlook web app, they can't send email on your behalf. The full Outlook client is required for that. You can give delegates access to your calendar by first sharing your calendar with them and then giving them permissions. The delegate will receive copies of all your meeting requests so they can respond on your behalf without having to open your calendar or inbox to do so. Appointments you have marked private are by default not viewable by a delegate, although you have the option to allow this. You can easily remove delegate access or downgrade a delegate's permissions to something less, like full details or limited details, for instance. You can also configure how your meeting requests are to be handled. If you want to be able to respond to meeting requests yourselves, you can select both delegate and me. If you just want to know that you have a meeting request but don't want to take action on it, you can select delegate only, send me notifications. And lastly, if you don't want to be bothered with meeting requests at all, you can simply select delegate only. You can also configure delegate access to your calendar from your tablet device by opening Outlook web app with a compatible mobile browser or OWA for iPad or iPhone, for instance. Have you ever experienced the pain of trying to locate a document a colleague has previously shared with you? Shared with me eliminates the worry of finding those important documents, as they are all now visible in a single view from within your SkyDrive Pro. The documents you see in the Shared with Me view may live on someone else's SkyDrive Pro or may be shared from a standard team site document library. Once documents are shared with you, you will have the same permissions you were given by the person that shared them with you. This means you can view a document, edit it, share it, download it, and more, as if it were natively stored on your own SkyDrive Pro. Members of a site can now share documents and the site itself without having to approve them through the site collection owner. When the site owner allows members to share on the site, anyone with at least editor permissions on a document will be able to share the document, and any user in the default members group for the site will be able to share the site. it's now possible to enable a core web part previously only available on-premises for dynamic publishing to showcase specific content based on a predefined search query. The content search web part uses SharePoint Enterprise Search technology to display dynamic results on a page. When you browse to a page that contains a content search web part, you're actually issuing a query. What's different with content search web part is that instead of you entering query terms in a search box, the query is contained within the web part itself. This means that when you browse to a page that contains a content search web part, a query is automatically issued. SkyDrive Pro for iOS now has a Tier 1 editing experience. Microsoft is adding two new capabilities to the existing SkyDrive Pro for iOS app. The additional capabilities fall under the improved integration with the other Office apps, Office Mobile for iPhone, Office Web Apps, and OneNote for iPhone. Integration with the Office Mobile for iPhone app and Office Web Apps for editing Word, Excel, and PowerPoint documents while maintaining file integrity in place in SharePoint Online, and integration with the OneNote app for viewing and editing notebooks. OneNote apps, as of this month, support Office 365. This new feature enables mobile editing of OneNote files stored in SkyDrive Pro. Let's take a look at a few of the previously shipped SharePoint Online platform improvements before diving a little deeper into others. Besides the previous update that increased SkyDrive Pro's default storage from 7 gigabytes to 25 gigabytes, in August of 2013, we added the ability to increase an individual user's storage beyond that default quota, up to either 50 gigabytes or 100 gigabytes. In September of 2013, we increased the capability of larger organizations to create up to 10,000 site collections from within their SharePoint Online admin console, or create them via PowerShell if they choose. To help improve the self-restore, we are increasing the amount of time a file will remain in the various recycle bins, so customers have a longer period of time for which they can restore a deleted document, list item, site, or even site collection. We've turned on versioning by default. Versioning helps with deletion errors and overwrite scenarios. We've increased the list lookup limit to add more lookup type columns to the lists and document libraries. The current limit is 5, we are increasing to 14. And SharePoint Online will now accept file types ending in .exe and .dll, previously blocked from being able to be uploaded to a customer document library. PowerMap is a 3D data visualization tool for Excel that provides an immersive experience for making discoveries in data that might not have ever been seen in traditional 2D tables and charts. PowerMap lets you plot geographic and temporal data visually, analyze that data in 3D, and create cinematic tours to share with others. With PowerMap, you can plot more than a million rows of data in 3D visually on Bing Maps and visualize the data with 3D columns, bubble or pie charts, heat maps, and regions. You can discover new insights by seeing your data in geographic space and seeing time-step data change over time. And we can share stories by capturing screenshots and building cinematic, guided, interactive, or video tours that can be shared broadly, engaging audiences like never before. Some of the new features in the September preview refresh include improved getting started experience, automatically plot data points when you launch PowerMap, recognizing the type of geo-characteristics your column of data have, for instance, latitude or longitude, city, state, country, region, etc. We have region visualization with new region-based visualizations that color code these geopolitical areas, zip code, county, state, for example, or during an election indicating status of polling by red Republican and blue Democrat states. Can map your data in its most useful form, either as globe or flat map, allowing comparison of 3D columns across the horizon and creating an intriguing visual effect when switching between two options. We can create a video tour optimized for mobile 360p, tablet's computer or 720p, and HD displays as 1080p. This is the first step in unlocking tours from the Excel workbook, as these videos can be shared anywhere, including social media, PowerPoint slides, and SkyDrive. We have expanding language support for user experience and data that can geocode in PowerMap to Spanish, Japanese, and Arabic. More languages will be coming soon. Support for calculated fields and hidden columns in PowerPivot. PowerPivot users can now map data in the data model when there are these commonly used modeling characteristics. And we can customize color schemes of our visualizations to fit our audience or personal preference. As I mentioned earlier, we also have updates to the social aspects of Office 365. So let's take a quick look at a few of these. Last November at the SharePoint conference, we announced our roadmap for enterprise social and talked about three phases of Yammer integration: basic integration, deeper connections, and connected experiences. Team collaboration often focuses on documents, and the easier it is to communicate about those documents, the easier it is to move projects forward. Having two-way conversations about documents in real time from within the documents themselves can not only enhance communication, it can also improve employee engagement and spark innovation. Included with the September 2013 updates, such productive social conversations about team documents are now possible within SharePoint Online. You can start a Yammer conversation for any document that is stored in a SharePoint Online document library or in SkyDrive Pro just by clicking Post, the new command that's available in document library callouts and search results for Office documents. By using Post to communicate with your peers about a document right from the context of that document, you can improve the discoverability of deliverables. You can use the new Post command only after the Office 365 tenant administrator has enabled Yammer as a default social network. To enable Yammer on your tenant, please check out the Make Yammer Your Default Social Network in Office 365 post in the Office 365 technology blog. You can now use the Search on Yammer link in the Office 365 search results page to forward your search query to your Yammer network. Lastly, let's take a look at the new features available to help manage your Office 365 tenant. First up, let's take a look at the features that have been available since September. Public folder mailbox size increase, Exchange online cutover migration limit increase, additional link online reports, link online spell check, and improving Outlook 2013 performance with Office 365. Public folder mailbox size has been increased to 50 gigabytes per mailbox. Tenants are provided 50 public folder mailboxes by default, but are automatically extended to 100 public folder mailboxes on demand. And customers migrating from Exchange 2003 are now provided hybrid license keys to temporarily host on-premises Exchange public folders for migration. We've increased the number of mailboxes supported for Exchange Online cutover migrations to 2,000 mailboxes. Three additional link online reports have been added to the integrated Office 365 Admin Center. Active users who have logged on, peer-to-peer audio-video minutes, and audio-video conferencing minutes. Previously, these stats were only accessible through PowerShell or REST reporting web services. Shipped in September of 2013, we've integrated spell check within the IM window of Link Online. Starting with the September 2013 update of Microsoft Outlook 2013, Microsoft is collecting additional information from client computers that connect to the Office 365 service. This information will help the Office 365 team to identify client connectivity issues and resolve them faster. The goal is to greatly improve the health and performance of the Office 365 service. The Office 365 team is focused on continuous improvements of all aspects of Office 365 service to make sure that our customers have a great experience. Some examples of the kind of information that will be collected include the time required to process a request with Office 365, the time required to retrieve free busy information from Office 365, and details about unsuccessful connection attempts made to Office 365. With the October 2013 update, enterprise customers now have a much faster and simpler option to set up a custom domain in Office 365 if they bring a domain purchase from GoDaddy. They will not need to manually add the DNS records to the GoDaddy website one by one. When users go through the domain setup wizard, they can provide their GoDaddy.com credentials, and then we'll add the required DNS records to their GoDaddy domain automatically. This will help prevent users making mistakes during the domain setup process. For users who don't want to use the automatic option, the manual option is still available. This feature will substantially improve the customer's experience around one of the most complex steps of setting up an Office 365 account. Please don't forget to check out the Office 365 technology blog. This is the best place to find further information about the updates discussed in this presentation, as well as the best place to find information and notifications of future updates. The Office 365 technology blog is located at http://blogs.office.com/b/office365tech. This concludes the inaugural installment of our ongoing series of Office 365 new features monthly updates. My name again is John Horner, and I work as a partner solution consultant within the Global Partner Services Division of Microsoft. I want to personally thank you for taking the time out of your busy day to listen in on this presentation, and I look forward to having you listen in on future monthly update sessions. So until next time, I hope you found this presentation informative and helpful.